Whoa, 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 too many questions, y'all. Let me break it down for you real quick. All right. It damn sure was a life-changing experience. I went in that theater one way and I came out another. A new man. I never been the same. I just remember showing up at the theater, you know, just another casual movie experience, you know, nothing too crazy. Little did I know that my life would change forever. So I bought my ticket back, and then I got some popcorn, made sure I was holding my pants up as I was walking around, because I had like 10 bags of candy in my jeans, you know, family size. Snuck it right past them motherfuckers. I didn't know what I was getting into, though. See, I remember going in and sitting down in the theater. It was kind of nice, because, like, I'm the only one there. I put my feet up. I reclined. I laid back. Popped one nut out of my jean hole. Undid my pants so let my belly hang out. It was nice. You know, the show was about to go down. So next thing you know, the trailer started, and I was already going in on that candy. I finished about 6 bags before the movie even started. But before you know it, the movie starts, and I was hitting every wave. Every time them girls hit a wave with them boards, I started screaming. I was like, oh, shit! Get it, boo! Get it, boo! Once the movie started, I couldn't take my eyes off the screen for a second. Every girl, every wave on every board, it meant something to me. It was like a metaphor for who I am as a person, you know. Matt just smiles. His smile, it radiated across the room. And every time I saw that sun-kissed hands on the silver screen, well, I pretended I was right there sunbathing next to them. It was the most beautiful thing I ever felt. Closed my eyes. And I could feel the sun rays tickling my ball sack, mainly the left one, because that's the one that was hanging closer to the screen. Next thing you know, it's go time for Anne Maria Chadwick. She drops in on that beautiful barrel, hugging it real tight. She having flashbacks. I'm having flashbacks. She wipes out, and I went unconscious. I saw my vision go black. She had her lips puckered up, fighting for air. Good thing Jet Ski Man showed up in time, because he saved both our lives. That day, you know, I found out who that actor was, and who the one who played Jet Ski, and I went and I drove to his house to thank him personally. He was my hero, and he didn't even know it. Then, boom, another wave comes crashing down, and he sinks to the bottom of the ocean. My eyes still bleeding. They still bleed to this day. That's why I don't go to the beach no more. Every time I step on the sand, they bleed. Then some random surf lady tries talking to Annie, telling her how to surf. I ran up to the screen, and bang, I smacked it with my cane. Next thing you know, my girl's flying, dropping in and splashes once more, and Boo Boo's shoulder hits the coral reef. Then I shed blood. When I shed, I shit my pants. I crossed the pain threshold, the doctors told me. My bowels let loose. Jet Ski Man to the rescue again, a.k.a. me, reincarnated. I was a spirit animal in that moment, giving her strength. I wasn't going to let her lose. And she knew this. My baby gets up and through the surf to win the gold. Ever since then, I always loved her for that, you know. She gave me the world. She gave me Blue Crush. That's why this film means so much to me. It just touched me in ways that a woman never will.